Welcome everyone to our D&D adventure podcast stream, whatever you like to call it. We have no name, but lots of adventures.
We still haven't gotten a name yet.
No.
We have a name.
Something tells me
we asked for one on day one.
Something tells me when we get to the final boss, it's like, wait, what's your guys' name? And that's the only time we ever hear it.
You expect us to be coordinated.
That is very true. A little recap of last time's game. So, last time, as Bale was on his way to the optometric clerk, the others decided to head their way to see... to head their way to the Coaststone with a guild hall of gnomes with important information about the potential attack from the sewages. For sewage. The sewers.
Sewers? Oh my God. We're off to a great start tonight.
It was a nice day until a cow fell from the sky and almost crushed the party.
It crushed Birdie.
With that being said, they realized that there was an airship that was kind of out of control, speeding very fast. And it wasn't until a group of gnomes decided to hire the party to help them commandeer the ship. They want to make sure they can protect the ship as much as possible, get rid of the goblins, and protect the hostages on board. Luckily for our group was successful. They were able to land the ship without any issue and save everyone on board. Now you're going to be heading to Coaststone. But before we begin, just a few announcements. One, if we make it to, we're at 44 followers. If we make it to 50, everyone in the party will get a magic item from list A, and then we'll set a new goal down the line. And
imagine what Milana would do with a magic item.
What else? Brody's gonna join us a little later. She'll jump in. She's getting off work. She'll join us on definitely before any type of battling or adventures happen. Any other announcements? I believe that's it. Follow us on... Well, you can follow this channel at Workout Gamer on Twitch. I'm doing great tonight.
You sound like me right now, just tired.
Instagram and Twitter at The Workout Gamer. So I'm going to go in and get everything pulled up and ready to go. As everyone is approaching Coaststone, you notice a carriage kind of pass by you. In an express carriage carrying Bale.
Bale!
He can
Howdy,
see.
Howdy, everybody. I can see again.
I died!
Come back.
I leave for a day and you die.
I got better.
Obviously, you're alive currently. And why does our satyr friend sound like he got older?
It's fine.
It's just a happenstance. It's not real.
It's not real. Nothing is real. Everything is permitted.
So, as you approach Coaststone, it's home of the huge port for the ocean seas, and it's home of the most technological creations. You see wagons with that beast of burden moving them. Machines that make no sense to a stranger of this town. A lot of the machines are powered either by magic or steam. The town is dominated by a population of gnomes. You see a handful of halflings, humans, and dwarfs. Almost all the buildings are made of a combination of wood and stone. Is there anything you'd like to do in town while we're here?
I need to go... Oh, sorry, go ahead.
No, go for it.
I need to go see the smith and buy a longsword.
Oh, okay. So, you find the district with all the weaponry and everything. You find the blacksmith. The blacksmith, it's quite interesting. On the outside, you see this big mechanical-looking creature, but it's not moving, and there's a sign on it around its neck.
How tall is it?
It's pretty tall. It's pretty large.
I've placed my hand on its, what would be its shin, and or boot.
Okay, so you do that. Do you read the sign, or do you?
Yeah, I'll read the sign. I want to see if anything happens. Yeah, read the sign.
All right. What's this place called again? My notes.
We need notes? What?
I know, right? It's like, welcome to...
the Noteless Dungeon Master. Ah, man. I had it a moment ago. There it is. It's back.
It's like, welcome to the smithy shop. No worries. This golem is out of commission.
Why would I be worried about a golem?
Would you like for to see a demonstration?
Please. They interest me quite a bit.
You see someone kind of like touch it. The golem kind of like activates. Grabs a couple of boulders that was behind it, crushes them, then deactivates. And they kind of turn the golem off.
That was quite astounding.
Yes, he was a quarry golem. This is my shop. How may I help you?
I am interested in purchasing a long sword weapon.
Yes, of course. Come on in. You see the gnome kind of open. You see this big door. There's an opening little handle for him to go through. And then there's a second handle for medium-sized creatures to go through. So it's two doors in one.
And I'm guessing large creatures just don't fit inside?
They're going to have to duck their head.
Duck their head. Okay, I'll open the second door.
All right, so you see that when you open the door, it connects back with the original door. It's like, oh, yes, just a regular longsword.
Do you have any kind of special weaponry besides just a basic longsword here? Or is basic the only you carry? Basic the only thing you carry?
I do have quite a few things, but it may be a little out of your price points. I do have very, very good armor as he kind of stares you down. I have +2 shields, +2 plate mail. +2 split mail.
Way out of my... plate mail is way, way out. You know what? I'll be back. I need to go talk with my adventuring crew and see how much we can scrounge together. What is the going price range for your +2... What you said? Scale mail?
We have split mail and plate mail. No, I would just say full plate, actually.
Yeah, full plate will definitely out. Split mail, there we go.
Split mail, that would be about 8,500 gold pieces.
Oh, yeah, mm-hmm. That's going to be a little out of our price range.
We don't have that.
Let's stick to the weaponry. What do we have weapon-wise?
We do have layer rate. unfortunately, I don't have any weapons, but I do have... we do have some other items as well. Some potions, some... a wand, but if that's a little pricey, the cheapest we have are the Potion of Heroism and Potion of Invulnerability, each for about 500 gold pieces.
Okay, I will bring my party back through this place. Is there a shop around here that does sell in weaponry?
We do have swords, so if no magical items, not that I know of. But we do have regular weapons here.
Okay. I will, while I'm here currently, purchase a long sword from you. What will that run me?
All right, whatever it says in the book.
15 gold pieces.
All so right. We have a special comment from one of our viewers, Hundo. Get your budget together, adventurers. Maybe use Robinhood.
I'll just talk to the fairies. The fairies will give me whatever I need.
While I take the long sword, I bring out my warhammer that I have been using in the past and see if they would want to purchase it from me.
It's like, oh yes, of course. Takes a look at it, notice it's been used, looks kind of looks at everything like, very nice warhammer. You sure you want to part with this?
Yes, I believe it's served me well. I've been more interested in blades as of late.
Okay. I'll be happy to take it off your hands for 5 gold.
5 gold. What would you say to 7?
Give me a persuasion.
Gotta scrimp that money.
Natural one.
All right, off to a great start. It's like, no. He starts pointing out different flaws. Like, if it was in better condition, I'd be happy to move to 7. Maybe even 8. But it looks like this has seen better days.
You've seen better days.
5 gold will do. And I
all right.
Place the hammer on the table.
All right. So he takes it. He starts cleaning up. He writes down on a couple of notes that it's going to be on an order to get it repaired and everything.
Okay. I'll walk back to the entrance of the city, hoping to find my crew.
All right. Okay, so you meet up with your crew. Does anyone else want to do anything else before moving on?
When he returns, he sees one Sir Nunos speaking with his donkeys once again, but not playing chess. And in fact, he's confirming that yes, these new and donkeyless carriages are they won't hurt them, and in fact I love them as the individuals that they are, and I would never let some machine take them away from me.
Okay. Okay.
I've never seen machinery because I'm used to living in a forest.
Okay.
So I'm just staring at all of the stuff and so confused. Slightly terrified. Slightly enthralled.
Okay, so go and give me a wisdom saving throw then, Milana.
Oh, good. An 8.
All right, so until you're in a quiet area, like an inn or inside or outside the city, any kind of check you make will have disadvantage just because you're kind of overwhelmed until you kind of get used to this area.
This is really overwhelming for me. It's like, machine. What are these? I'm gonna smash it!
All right.
No smashing. Yes, they are giant.
I don't like it!
You already died once. You don't need to die to these things.
I need a tree! Danger!
Do either of you two want to tell me why we are here? Exactly.
I don't remember.
Sir Nunos, would you like to explain what we are doing in...
We are here to... In Coastone, the home of the ice cream, to speak with the Guild of the Gnomes. And we will be telling them that King Greg Hasselhoff has sent us to parley with him about the evil memness that will be overflowing from the sewers post-haste.
Gnomes! That's right, gnomes!
Yep. Gonna be attacked through the sewers? Yep. So, let's find the Guild of Gnomes.
Let's make our way, and I'll flag down what looks like a city guard and ask them where I can find, where myself and my adventuring party can find the Guild of the Gnomes.
Okay. So, they do point you in a certain direction. They're like, oh yes, of course it's over there. And, this place, it's a pretty nice, like hall. It's one of those things where it's like, you know, kind of like the mayor's office type of thing or a government building. It's huge. It's very, well made. Half of it's timber, half of it is like very fine iron furnishings, decorated and whatnot. You see all these different symbols of like different guilds and whatnot, but you also see a receptionist.
There's I'll walk up to the receptionist.
Yes, may I help you?
Yes, my crew, my adventuring party, and I were sent by
King David Hasselhoff. Greg Hasselhoff.
Greg Hasselhoff.
Keeps changing.
Yeah. It's Greg.
I'm going with King Greg Hasselhoff. He wishes to speak of a parley. There is a menace that is coming to attack from the sewers.
Bat King?
Oh, yes, of course. Let me go ahead and I'll be right back. I'll go and speak with them right now, and I'll be sure to get you an audience.
Make it fast. This is of everyone's. This affects your whole city's health.
The receptionist looks at you, slowly walks away and turns their head, and it goes immediately to the guild hall masters.
Many machines!
Sir Nunez, go and give me a perception check.
Okay. Not a good start.
Let's get all the bad rolls.
I think I got a 12. Yeah,
get the bad ones out of the way.
Let's see. Perception. Even worse. How did that get lower? What in the... 9.
How did that get lower?
It's 9.
Okay. You kind of hear a few things. One of the reception person named Hundo, thanks for the comments in the chat, kind of say, hey, that Sir Nunez sounds pretty dreamy right now. Thanks, Hundo, for the for the extra commentary. We could definitely add that.
You have perception, performance, and persuasion all next to each other, so I keep getting confused on which one I'm actually looking at. And it's just like, why are all of these ones right next to each other? What cruel deity did this?
The alphabet?
Lord Alphabet.
Lord Alphabet has struck again!
Makes
run for your lives!
I hate the alphabet. It's stupid.
So the receptionist comes back and leads you. She kind of beckons you this way. You enter in this grand hall where they have meetings. You see a gnome approach a podium. And it's like, ladies and gentlemen, we have our guild hall leaders here today. We have our gnome artificer, Miss Mina Beltunnel.
Yeah.
And of course, an elder of our venture, a gnome wizard named Goldman.
Nah.
You see the male wizard walk up. Everybody have a seat. What brings you adventurers to our kingdom? Would you like some milk?
I want milk.
Well, please get them some milk. You're handed like a nice little pint of milk. Please proceed. What you want to talk about?
Jesus.
I will chug my milk.
Dash had better listen to this because that is a spot on impersonation of Goldman.
Excuse me, your grand wizardness.
Yes, dreamy one.
Yes. We were sent by King Greg Hasselhoff because we found information and reported to him that it insinuates that a horde of orcs may be gushing forth from your sewers tonight or very soon on some night.
That's not good. Mina really steps up. Well, if this be true, do you have any of the plans or notes to prove this?
Oh my, I don't remember if I said I took the plans.
I thought you did.
No, but I do have this writ from the king, I believe, right?
Yes, that's what I was talking
I
about.
I have a writ from the king saying that we are come by him to impart this very information, and if you need further than our own words to find... here you go, I'll just let you read it.
Do you have the notes from... do you have evidence of this? I don't remember. Is this person alive? I don't know.
So, fun story about our game yesterday. clearly, only one person takes notes. So, yeah, when I was asking about a certain character, everyone looked at this like a deer in headlights. I don't remember. Do I take care of this person? The answer was yes, she's in jail.
The one person who had the notes that knew if this person was alive or not, their computer decided to not work, so they couldn't talk.
Look what happens when I miss a week.
No, yeah. This was me last night. I couldn't get through because my computer's like, what? What is this lurk you speak of? No, there's no working.
So
only here, no speak.
So as they kind of take the notes and everything, Mina says, very well. You, champions, we are going to need your help. We are going to make sure if there's any attack up from above, we'll be preparing our defenses. While you will be heading to the sewers. If there's any reason or any, if there is any intruders, please take care of them. We cannot risk us losing this town. And if we can defeat them, this will definitely turn the tides of this unfortunate attack from these ogres or these orcs.
I smashed kneecaps! Oh, what happened?
Oh, Bale will be right back.
Oh!
So, well, our champions, please go forth.
Before we go, I was wondering, do you have any flares that we might shoot into the air to announce if we find the horde and need backup?
You'll be underground. That's not a bright idea.
There are no manholes or rain grates or anything that we might announce our presence from?
No, it's a sewer.
All right. Never mind. Enjoy your milk, and we will tell you of our success later.
They both stand up. Everyone, like, court adjourned. Everyone kind of goes to their own, everyone kind of goes to their, back to their own business. Goodness, my voice hurts, so Goldman's going to be gone for a while.
What do you mean? What do you mean your voice hurts? It's not like I've made tea with honey because the voice I chose was a terrible mistake.
So, Dash, if you're listening, that was all for you, bud. So, is there anything you want to do before they lead you to the sewers?
I chug the milk I have.
I wipe the milk that I previously chugged off of my lips and say, forward to adventure.
All right.
Hopefully,
I think
we find
still asleep back at the table. Bale.
I'll pick up Bale and give him a shoulder to weep upon as we exit the guild hall.
Okay, I'm going to need you to make a strength check if you're going to be picking up Bale.
I got a 3.
Okay.
Did you say 3?
Even with the additional milk powers, you're not strong enough to even lift him.
Well, Bale will have to let himself out because I am too weak to pick up his armored ass.
Oh, look, Bale's awake.
Sorry, I guess that milk must have knocked me out. I'm
a
bit
lactose intolerant. You make poor choices when you leave.
Apparently, you make very poor choices when I leave.
This time, at least we were just trying to carry you.
Yes, the elderly frail man was trying to carry me.
I'm an average strength man. I just rolled a 3. I didn't have my feet beneath me properly.
Here, I'm going to teach you a lifting technique.
Oh?
Can I carry you? Bale, can I carry you?
Give us a proper lifting tutorial, Bale. You said it, so we're happy.
Just stand beside Zernunos and I put my feet shoulder length apart and I try to have him follow in suit. Might be a little harder for you with your cloven hooves and whatnot, but try to...
I get the shoulder width apart, yes.
Okay. Bend at your knees. Keep your back straight.
Which set? The front or the back?
You have one set of knees. You don't have two.
Look, my hooves,
you're
and then I've got my back knee, and then it comes up to the front knee, and then up to my hip. I've got the feet, the legs of a deer, you know.
Bale is giving this tutorial to Sir Nunos, I want to walk up behind him and try to pick him up.
Who, Bail or?
Bail, of course.
Okay, yeah, go for it.
Because I'm psycho. Oh, good. This is good. This is gonna be good. 19.
So, you quickly like go ahead and grab like his lower body, his center of gravity, start picking them up, and you do it with relative ease. You pick him up, put him back down, and it was very impressive.
I walk around to the front and was like, I did it right!
I just pointed our little halfling friend.
Milana!
I'm a gnome!
Milana. That is how you're supposed to lift, Sir Nudos. Just as so. Fair. Work on your lifting technique.
I sure do that!
As you're working on this, one of the Councilman Hundo, tells Sir Nunos, yo, stop skipping leg day.
I like
I'll have to work like on that in my mind.
It's fine.
I'm going to pull out a book that says leg day.
I was going to write that down.
As if it was important. No.
Thank you very much.
Keegan, are you dying?
Yeah, Keegan's dying. It's okay.
Yeah, I gotta lift my dead ass body up, and I gotta teach a satyr how to lift, and he's talking about knees.
So go ahead. Would you like to try another chance of lifting, Sir Nunos?
Fine. Get on the floor, Bill. I'll try one more time.
Whoa!
Get on the floor.
Regardless of where he's at, I try again. I get a 12.
Okay, so as you go and get into a nice deadlifting position, you start picking him up, and you see all these veins just like starting to activate in his arms and his legs, and the song Hearts on Fire from Rocky IV starts to play in his head as he gets Bale off the floor like maybe a foot, but puts him back down.
Yes. Oh, my back knees there. That was a bit much. Excuse me.
I'm going to saunter towards the closest sewer hatch.
All right. As you guys are being escorted to the sewer hatch, you notice Birdie has arrived. And you see a couple of gnomes kind of poking at Birdie's arms like, whoa, you have arms.
What's up? I've actually been here the whole time. I just took a vow of silence until they put a bird fountain in the middle of town.
But then why are you talking? I'm pretty sure the fountain's not there.
Oh, it's there? Talking. Or they've lied to me, in which case we have bigger problems.
Come back and pay them wrath and terror if it's not there when we come for our paths after the sewer.
Yes, give them a good squawking too.
Squawk, squaw, 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 like that.
Birdie, we have been given our charge. We are to take to the sewers and smash the enemies there. Well, you will do the smashing, and I'll stay back and find toads or something. I don't know.
Sounds good. I love smashing.
All right.
Make our way.
I love smashing. Smashing's great.
So they take you to the sewage system, and they have like a kind of like an iron door that's locked and everything. They open it up, and you see a flight of stairs that descend into the sewers.
Do you take them? Let's
go. I'll take charge.
I start with a perception check.
Okay, yeah.
I get a 21.
Cool. What are you trying to find?
So I'm looking to make sure that there aren't any fresh cobwebs that will be disturbed as we pass through. And if so, I will carefully move them out of the way so that the spiders don't get smashed by a large paladin man. And so then from there, I'm going to look down the walls and the steps and make sure that there's no slippery things that are going to make us fall on our asses. And then from there, I'll look for traps.
So kind of like before he goes down, you're just kind of scanning.
Sure, I'll give it the once over.
Okay, so with your roll, you are able to find that not so much any kind of like you don't find any webs or anything since it's closer up to the surface. From what you can see, do you have dark vision?
No.
So you can only see until it starts getting darker and darker as it descends down into in down to the depths. So only where the light can hit is what you can see. But from what you see, the steps are actually made of stone, very finely crafted stone. And as you listen closely, you can kind of hear water dripping every now and then. But other than that, because you don't have dark vision, that's all you can see.
Can I do a history check on the stone?
Yeah.
Okay. So because I am a dwarf, I have stone cunning.
Okay.
So I get proficiency on the history check and double my proficiency bonus.
Nice.
So 14 plus 4, and then proficient in it lets me add intelligence. So 19 total.
So you know that this is finely crafted dwarven stone. Based on the steps, you know, it was made for definitely a medium creature. So for the gnomes who may have to come down here every now and then, it's big for them. So Milana, it might be a little bit of an issue climbing.
I'm having a great time. Yeah. I'm having a great time just jumping down to each step.
Yeah, it's kind of hard for you to kind of like run down if you wanted to, but you have to take your time getting down. Other than that, it's very solid, very finely cut, and it is of dwarven work. You can tell, like, just based on that and looking at the walls, that you can possibly discover, like, oh, they probably hired dwarves to do this.
This seems like very sturdy stairs and a very sturdy wall.
The rocks are very hard.
Yes.
They're what?
Solid stone, one would say.
Milana, you can't see in the dark, correct?
I can see.
Oh, never mind.
I have dark vision.
Birdie, do you need light?
No, I can see in the dark.
Oh.
You might be.
You can see in the dark. I'm the only blind one. Good.
feel free to cast light if you want to.
Well, I thought about it, but I didn't want it on me in case bad guys showed up.
Let's move forward. And point it at Ser Nunos. If you'd like to cast light, use my blade.
It's okay. Go forward, and I shall trip along the way.
Okay.
Okay. So as you descend down further and further, some of the stones start to get covered with water and moss. The smell is very foul. It's a combination of waste and stagnant water. It's dark.
Almost action gag.
It's dope. It's dark and yet no sign of light. So
I take out a hanky and wrap it around my face, giving me a slight layer of protection against the smell.
Okay, so it's not as bad. It's still pretty foul.
It's terrible. But I've been in worse. One time I was in there was a creature that had washed up upon the shore. I named it Hexer Biddlehole, and its stomach had burst out of it. Don't worry about it. Let's continue on the adventure.
Oh, no, I'm interested in this. What was its name?
Bisfiliolo. And see, it had the greatest fin upon the top of its back, and it seemed to swim like a seahorse, but instead of a horse shape, it was more, well, it was more like a blade made of seven pointy axes, and its teeth were like 19 knives coming down trying to chop if it was alive. It was scary. I don't suggest meeting them.
Oh, wait.
Are you actually describing a real animal?
I'm guessing whatever in the milk that knocked me out is affecting you two.
You were saying, Birdie? I heard you trying to...
Well, I was just asking if the axes that it was made of, were they for stabbing?
These were teeth made of bone or some other substance. I was unable to give it further examination because I was run off by a pack of wild wolves. They had come to feast upon the carcass.
Why'd you leave insight the wolves? Check. They're so nice.
Oh, yeah, go for the insight check.
14.
You believe some of his words? The other ones, you feel like, I feel he's mixing a couple of stories together.
Just and, a few.
The people just viewing, you are looking at the map that I made of the sewer. If you're a player, please don't look at the map.
Okay. No, I'm
kidding.
Okay.
Oops.
No, it's fine. I made this map with a website called inkcarnets.com. Not sponsored in any way, but it's cool. You can make maps. You can make world maps and everything. There's a free version and a paid version. It's pretty cool to look at. So again, not sponsored. Just throwing some out some love.
And, because they do such a good job of making maps for us to enjoy, for you.
So when it comes to drawing, I'm somewhat illiterate. So this helped a lot. So onward to the adventure. So it's been, you got, after Cernunos's tirade of many stories, I need you all to give me a perception check. Disadvantage for you, Cernunos, because you cannot see.
That's fair.
Ooh, goody.
Got an 8.
Okay.
Non-natural 20.
Okay.
17.
Okay.
14.
All right. So Birdie and Birdie, Milana, and Cernunos, you all hear footsteps coming your way. Milana, you also see a torch that is lit being carried coming down your way.
I tug on Bale's armor and go, torch! Torch!
You want to remind me what we're looking for down here?
Orcs?
Oh, my divine sense isn't going to help me find orcs. My blade's already drawn.
Efren, judging by the sound of it, how close are they?
They're, like, down the hall. They're getting closer and closer.
Okay. Is there any nook or cranny that might fit the four of us?
No.
Not, like, a little alcove or something?
No, it's a straight line.
Is there a corner of a hallway?
It's a straight line.
Okay. I just hoped.
Great. A straight line. Does it have any bends and turns in it?
Not where you are.
Okay, obviously, Milana told me or pointed out where they were. Now, is it just a torch I can see, or can we see the creature, or like a body? Not specifically the creature, but like, can I make out?
You rolled an 8, so you just see the person that's holding the torch. It's a humanoid figure.
I'm going to...
I noticed anything.
Command. And tell it to halt.
All right. That's a pretty good roll. 16.
16 will succeed.
All right. You just hear... Boss, there's someone down here. Let's get him.
Oh,
roll
fuck.
Initiative.
Ooh, goody.
Dang it. Okay.
That's not the dice I wanted to roll. Well.
All right. So, 20 or higher.
15
or higher.
18.
All right, so I heard 19 from Birdie.
Yep.
Bale got 18.
All right. Bale got 18. Cernunos, what'd you say?
14.
Okay. What did you get, Milana?
8.
All right. So... first up is Birdie. You see two humanoid creatures approaching you down this hallway.
How close are they?
If you run up to them, you can get to them.
Oh, sweet, sweet. Okay, I'm going to run up to them with my battle axe, my plus one battle axe, because I can. Wait, no. Just kidding. With my great axe, my plus one great axe, I'm going to hit them. I'm going to hit them with my battle. My great. I'm going to hit them with an axe.
Which one are you going to hit? You're going to hit the one the holding one that, the torch, or that called for the boss, or the boss?
The one with the torch, because I want to snuff that light out.
Okay, yeah.
Let's go. 16 to hit.
Oh, yeah, that hits.
Perfect. And then he's going to take D12. Because I can and I want to. Oh, that was a 12. So he's going to take 17 damage.
All right. So you kind of just slice him in half. His body just drops the torch. It's still lit. And it's shining upon you and the boss.
I don't like that.
Next can up. I both? Oh, go ahead.
But- torch out.
No, you did your attack. You cannot do that.
Just I sit on the torch. Wait, no, I don't want to do that. I take that back. Never mind.
Can I please sit on a
on active a fire? Flame? Sure.
I want to sit on this active torch.
Bale, it is your turn.
Can I make out now that the light is on the boss creature? What creature or what it is? Human, orc.
You see him dressed in clothing that's kind of like a uniform. He is human. He is human.
I'm gonna try and through intimidation get them to stop attacking and talk to us. Explaining that we are down here to hunt down orcs and have no need to fight humans that are in the area.
Okay, roll a persuasion.
Use intimidation instead?
Try yeah, like intimidation, sorry, it. Yes.
Okay. That's a 20. Not natural, dirty okay. 20.
It's like, oh, you're here for orcs.
This you have is great. Response?
Yes, and unless you'd like to end up like your friend there, split in half, I'd advise you to drop your weapons.
It's like, okay, okay. well, if you're here for orcs, then, by all means. He takes his sword, and he's going to go ahead and swing at
So the Birdie. Only person that's close enough is Birdie, so.
Yep.
To him.
He'd have to go by you to get to me.
By you,
you get.
You see him drop one short sword. He puts his hands up and grabs out a long sword and another short sword.
Oh, is he still fighting us? Dude just carries
three swords? What the hell?
Yeah, have you ever seen One Piece? It's great.
I have. This is not Zoro. Zoro uses three katanas.
So Birdie does that.
Zoro has a rapier.
It's a different character from an anime.
Oh. The correct Zorro.
The correct Zorro does have a rapier.
And a whip.
That is true.
And a beautiful, beautiful horse.
Well, this Zorro has green-ass hair and it's called Mosshead.
That is an incorrect Zorro, thank you.
As Bale and Milana fight about the stories of Zorro, does a 17 hit Birdie?
Yeah.
All right. All right, so he's going to take a attack from a longsword first.
Mm-hmm. My best sword is Guy Williams.
You're going to take 8 damage.
Well,
second attack, an 8 won't hit you.
Mm-hmm.
And with his short sword, a 22.
Oh, probably. Boy.
Not damage, but to hit.
Yeah.
He's going to do 5 damage to you.
Okay.
Next up is Sir Nunos.
I take my staff with the pine cone atop it, and I rush at the beast in front of me. And at the last moment, I throw it over my head and hit him with my horns. Hopefully. I miss. I miss terribly.
Okay.
Well, that's
I got a 7.
No, that's not going to hit. Milana, your turn.
I rage!
All right.
Which means wild magic, baby! What do we get? Ooh! Until my rage ends, I'm surrounded by multicolor protective lights.
Okay.
I gain a +1 bonus to AC, and while within 10 feet of me, my allies gain the same bonus.
So what's the bonus again? Say it again.
+1 to AC.
Oh, nice.
And then I charge after him with my maul.
Okay.
Screaming all the way. Does a 14 hit?
No.
Oh, oops.
All right, back to the top. Birdie.
Don't. I'm going to hit him again. Okay. But the guy attacked me. I'm going to hit him real hard.
Okay.
The boss, bitch. Okay. Gosh. A 20, but not natural.
That hits?
Heck yeah, it does. Okay.
No, it doesn't. Not at all. We found God down here.
12 damage?
Yes, I'd like to insult his mother.
All
right. Another smelt of hamsters and your father sold the elderberries.
Mm-hmm.
Next up is more- Bale.
Are they within 30 feet?
Oh,
or?
Yeah.
Okay, so that takes that out. Yeah, I got 25. So if they're within 30, I will make my way up. if I head straight for the boss, am I going to take an attack of opportunity from the secondary guy?
No, the other guy's dead.
He did.
I thought there were 3 in total. You said one with the torch, one without, and a
no,
boss.
No, there's
2. Okay, cool. Going for the boss, sword drawn. I'm going to make a stabbing motion as I charge forward, kind of like have it under me so that I can come up with my weight into his chest area.
Okay.
That's a 10.
No.
Uh-oh.
Wait a second. I'll let it pass. Never mind.
Wait! Never mind.
There's Birdie. There, all of you are pretty much up in front. So he's going to go ahead.
I hit him so hard.
He's going to go ahead and attack Birdie, what? Bale, and Milana. First up is Birdie.
Remember, you have +1 to your AC.
I believe a 13 won't hit.
Oh, no. A 13 will not, because Bale. I have 1.
12 probably doesn't hit.
Nope.
Milana.
A +1's really helping right now.
A 9 probably doesn't hit.
No.
Wow, this is terrible.
It goes straight over my head. I don't even notice it.
You do notice that he used a short sword against you. And you feel that's kind of insulting?
That's insulting!
It is now.
I remember every insult, and I nurse as resentment.
All right, Sir Nuno's your turn.
Oh, I thought he'd be dead already.
Not. We can't hit him.
I will reach down, pick up my staff. And no attempt to smash him on the head.
Okay.
Dude, how wide is this
sewer? Does a 16 hit?
No.
What?
Oh. Then I pass.
Jeez. Back to Milana.
I'm going to reckless attack now because I'm insulted that he used a short sword against me.
All right.
And that will be... I know math. 23!
That hits.
God!
I've done the impossible.
That will be a 12 damage to his kneecaps.
All right. His kneecaps starting to hurt.
They better start hurting.
All right. Next up is back to Birdie.
How dare you use a short sword?
Cool. What I'm gonna do?
Okay, Jake Peralta.
Cool. I'm gonna put away my axe. I'm gonna get out 2 little axes. One per hand.
Because you have hands.
I'm gonna. I have arms, so I must have hands. So I'm going to attack him twice now because I have two weapons.
Go for it.
Ooh, one's a nat 20, baby.
Nice.
And then we have a 16 plus 8, which is going to be a 24.
All right, so go and do your non-natural 20 damage while I roll up what might happen to him.
Nope. Okay, 9. So without the nat 20, it's a 19.
19 damage?
Yeah.
All right, 1 second. Critical hit, critical hit. So that's a 64. So 64 will be table 32. What are you using again? Hand axes?
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Uh-oh.
Okay, so...
You cut off his arms.
Oh. I get to keep his arms. Now I have 2 seconds.
You now have 4 arms!
Oh my god.
So you're going to get your first one. So what are you using? Hand axes, which is a d6, right?
Yes.
Roll me 3 more d6s.
Oh my god. Hold on.
Oh my god.
He dead.
Another 9.
He dead.
At this point, he better be.
6, 5, 2.
Yeah, we're going to keep missing, so we better kill him 11, now.
13. So, with that 13, you go ahead and slice him. It would have blinded him if he were survived, but you chopped off where his eye levels off. Oop. Right off his head.
Rip.
And he is gone.
Oh, unfortunate.
I'm going to take advantage of this opportunity to scientifically examine the brain of this man before me.
You have half of a brain to
split in half, and I get to examine deep within where I've never seen a brain before.
Right. I smash another kneecap because I'm still angry about the short sword.
All right. what would you guys like to do?
Well, there's not another guy?
No,
you killed him already.
There was two.
Yeah. Wait, I thought there were three. Hold on.
I start looking through his pockets.
All right. So you find on a combination of both characters, there's leather armor, a scimitar, a light crossbow, splint mail, a long sword, a short sword, a heavy crossbow, a gold ingot worth 50 gold pieces.
Oh, stop.
The long sword was his.
Yep.
I steal it because I don't get the short sword.
And
may I take that splint mail?
All right. Are you going to attempt to put it on?
Yeah, I'll spend 10 minutes. Hold on. Beforehand. I walk back to Cernudos.
Yes?
Do you have a way to check if this is cursed or if there's anything wrong with it before I try to put this on my body?
I'm going to start out with just a good old-fashioned... I'll do Knowledge Arcana. And I got a 27.
There's no curses at all, but you do happen to find a symbol. A symbol that is on it.
I'm going to think back on my studies of the histories of this world. And that's a 20.
Okay, so you know that one of the symbols, yep, the symbol on it is a combination of two. One symbol is of the Shrine of Chaos, his insignia. The other one you've never seen before.
Do a religion check on the symbol as well. Okay. See if it's a religious symbol. That is... Oh, fuck it. That was a 19. That's a 10.
So, you know the Shrine of Chaos one. You've seen it before. You've been there. You've been to the shrine before. You've seen this insignia before. Milana? Go and give me a perception check.
No.
So you look at the symbol, and out of everyone, you're the only one that recognizes the other half. You what recognize the insignia from a group of as known as the Marauders, who came and attacked your village when you were younger.
Die! We must die! And I smash the bodies more.
Okay, I'm gonna take the time to put on the splint.
So throughout this whole 10 minutes, Milanus is going to town destroying these bodies. Because just by looking at the symbol, it just upset her.
Okay, so obviously seeing this is upset. Is the, while I'm putting the armor on, is the symbol on the inside or the outside? Like, is it visible?
It is visible.
I'm going to take my smith's tools and just, like, smash and etch it out.
Okay.
I feel like we could have used that to our advantage.
Probably could have, but it makes our barbarian even angrier at the time, and I don't feel like the one being smashed, so we're gonna knock that out.
Efren, the whole time that Milana is smashing on the body, I'll just be casting prestidigitation, trying to keep it as
intact as like possible.
Yeah, as intact as possible, just to frustrate her just a tiny little bit more.
Well, when it starts getting etched out, it starts to. I mean, you don't fix
them,
it. You just clean
one
it
of
up.
Them was a guy.
Right, exactly. I know that it doesn't limping, fix right? a dead body.
What was that, Milana?
Either one was limping, right? When they reversed
no.
them?
None of them were limping.
Oh, he's not the one I need to return the mall to.
We will find him.
He will die!
Was there a note on either of these two men?
No.
What?
No note? Okay. I say we continue down the way they came from. Actually,
that's right.
Obviously, if they came from somewhere, there may not have been orcs down that way. Should we head the opposite direction?
The opposite direction is back upstairs.
Half a Shrine of Chaos, and the other half was Marauders, right?
Yes, and they were, like, combined.
Okay.
One another.
Just wanted to make sure.
I say we continue.
Forward!
Yeah!
Are you okay, Milana? Do you feel better now?
No one will recognize their bodies now.
Question. Ooh. Is anybody particularly needing a heal or two?
Ooh, yeah.
I'm fine.
Fine at the moment.
All right.
It figures one of them will use short sword on me.
I look around me and hopefully see some moss hanging or growing on the wall. And if so, I will touch the roots or some form of nature and heal for, that is 11 damage, health.
Oh yeah, there's moss growing. It's pretty well
perfect
down here.
It's more so for me than anything else, but, you know, nature's got me covered, you know.
It's all good. So, do you continue on?
Yes.
Yeah.
So, as you continue on, you notice that there's, like, the hallway turns right. Like, as you get to the end of the hall, it turns, like, a hard 90-degree angle right. And as you continue down the hall, you feel that the temperature's starting to rise. As sweat drips down your head and hits the ground, it quickly evaporates. Bale, for you wearing this armor, it's getting very steamy in here.
I'll pop a divine sense. Are there any celestial fiend or undead within 60 feet?
No. Does that elemental count?
No.
Okay, then.
But.
No. So I'm taking it there might be an elemental?
I think there might be an elemental around here somewhere.
I wonder what could possibly be here.
You hear snickering and laughing going on as you enter this room. Bale, you kind of feel like they're kind of laughing at you.
I'm going to let out a boastful kind of roar of, reveal yourself to me, those who would laugh in my presence.
Oh, I have a question. Can
yes,
I use magical awareness
Does that allow you to see elementals?
It'd be magical.
Wait,
oh, no. It's meant for a spell or a magic item. Never mind.
All right. so,
I don't think they're a spell or a magic item.
You challenge this this snickering, and you see a total of 8 steam mephits appear out of the steam. Roll initiative.
Oh, good.
Are steam mephits flying? Do they crawl? What do these things look like? I don't even know.
Think of. Let me go see my picture.
Are they?
That's definitely okay. That's like
a very like goblin photos. Thing with wings made of steam.
Oof.
Yeah. Yeah, that's definitely the vibe I'm getting off by looking at this.
All right. 20 or higher.
Let's see. Nope.
15 or higher.
18.
Oh, good.
I'm pretty sure I'm last.
10 or higher?
12.
5 or higher?
6.
What'd you get, Birdie?
7.
All right.
I was right.
First up is Bale. You see 8 of these little creatures all laughing at you.
I'll attack the one directly in front of me, if there is one directly in front of me.
Sure, yeah. They're paired in twos. So, yeah,
you I'll try and...
to a pair.
And they're made of steam, I'm guessing, correct?
Yes.
Is it possible that, obviously, since they're made of steam, cutting through one in, like, a slicing action at a perpendicular angle to my body, so across hits them both, or no?
No, unless you had a special ability to do that.
Nope, just want to check. No cleave.
Okay.
That's a 7. Why am I getting great initiative rolls?
No, you swing, and they start giggling and laughing uncontrollably.
Oh, wait, hold on. Actually, I think that might be a 9. I don't know if that changes it, but
no.
Would a 9 hit?
No.
How does dueling work? Where's dueling? Wielding a melee weapon in one hand, no other weapons. Plus 2 bonus to damage, not attack rolls. No, okay.
It is now Sir Nuno's turn.
Ah! You said that they were flying, yes? Or are they currently on the ground?
Yeah, they're on the ground.
Perfect! How much... Oh, crap. How much is Bale in the center of this mass?
He's not in the center mass. He ran off towards a pair of two. They're kind of like surrounding you guys.
All right, I'm going to cast Web. So I conjure a mass of thick, sticky webbing. So I'm going to act like I'm going to cough up a loogie, but instead it just shoots out and it's a spider's web, and it fits, the webs fill a 20-foot cube from that point for the duration. So I want to get as many as possible.
I'm going to say this, since you guys are in the center, that's going to hit
We're
everyone.
In the center.
So think about this.
I didn't understand that.
You guys are in the center. There's 2 to your front, 2 to the west, 2 to the east, 2 to the south.
Never mind. I don't hawk anything. I will instead enlarge my good friend Bale. Okay. And I believe I can do that at range. Yes, I can. So I instead decide not to cough or anything, and I say, "Hey, Bale! You're looking a little tall over there." And then all of a sudden, he grows into a giant man.
All right. I believe you get some extra bonus damage for that, Bale.
Yeah, he gets... he has advantage on attack rolls. Okay. And...
Okay.
Let's see. A success, yes. Affected creature returns to normal. Size, big punch, advantage on strength checks, saving throws.
Technically, it's strength checks, not attack rolls. But your weapons are bigger, they're enlarged, and they deal an extra d4 of damage. Do attacks count as strength checks?
No.
Damn!
All right, next up, Birdie.
Dope. So here's what's going to happen. We're ready? I'm going to take my hand axes and swipe one at one and one at the other in front of me. Because I'm going to go off on my own and do my own little smoke pixies.
Pick a west, east, or south.
Let's go west, because they were my high school rivals. Let's go.
Go for it.
What's a high school?
What's revenge? Okay, let's go. The first pixie is going to get attacked with an 18.
That hits.
The second pixie, they're not pixies, but I don't care. They are close enough. Ooh, it's going to take a 20, but not natural.
Both hit.
Sweet. So, the first one, going to take 8 damage.
Okay.
This one is going to take also 8 damage.
Sweet.
And then all the last. Right.
Still alive. They didn't like that. Next up, Milana.
Ah, I'm confused. So I just smash one. Wait, how small are they? Are they big?
They're your height.
I smash one over the top of the head.
East or south?
East.
Oh, okay.
East. That will be a 15 to hit.
All right. Yeah, that hits.
Goody. Right. 11.
11 damage.
I smack him for 11. All and right. Just continue to stare because I'm still confused.
He's not looking too good.
He shouldn't.
All right, next up is the Mephits.
Uh-oh.
Everybody, give me 2 dexterity saving throws.
Two of them?
Yeah. Because you're surrounded by next to 2 of them.
I got 9.
Okay.
And 18.
The 18 passes.
I got a nat 20 and a 15.
All right. You pass on both.
I have advantage. Okay, hold on. Oh, no. A 12 and a 13.
Do you pass on both?
Oh, good.
Sir Nunes?
I got... this was a constitution, right?
Dexterity.
Oh, even better. 16 and a 14.
Both pass.
Hooray!
So... everyone's going to take a total... Except Bale is going to take a total of 4 fire damage.
Ouch.
Bale, you're going to take... No, I'm sorry. You all take 2 fire damage. Bale takes 4 damage.
Oh. These guys are cute.
That tickles.
All right, back to the top. Bale.
With my nat 20, can it just be like, have caught my clothes? I'm like, what? I'm so confused.
Yeah, it was a nice little warm breeze.
It was a nice little warm breeze going by. It's like, okay.
My attack again misses for 9.
All right.
Woo!
Sir Nunes, your turn. God, I can't wait till you get to the boss.
I once again drop my bow staff, my walking stick, and I will reach back for my crossbow, but decide no. Instead, I'll get out my sling and I'll whip it around and attack.
Okay.
And miss.
With what?
An 8.
Okay. Ooh, you guys are doing well. Back to Birdie.
Yeah, I'm just going to do what I did before because it worked. Let's go, Birdie. First one. Ooh. It's going to take a 25.
That is. Hit.
Second one. Ooh, that one's a little bit lower. That one's going to be a 16 to hit.
They both hit.
Dope. So, the first one's going to take. Are we ready? Oh, 7 damage.
Cool.
Numero dos. I'm going to take 6 damage.
Consistency. I like it. All right. Yeah. Milana, your turn.
Still very confused. So I hit the one I hit before.
All right.
For a 13.
That hits.
Okay, then. I'm going to swing like a baseball bat with my ball. I'm going to send that little sucker flying.
Go for it.
Ooh, cool. Another 11.
All right. As you swing with your maul with like a baseball bat, you immediately hit him. It hits him across the face, and his whole body explodes. Give me a dexterity saving throw.
Uh-oh. That would be a... 13.
Cool, you pass. You're only going to take 1 damage from it.
Oh, my God. Again, just confused. I want to look at the other one.
All right.
And go.
Do you even take the damage? Or are you not raging? Never mind.
I'm not raging. Because they're not making me angry. I'm just confused by them.
They're so very cuddly and cute looking.
They're so tiny and everything. And I just look at the other one. It's like, do you want that to happen? Because you're next.
They're going to go ahead and attack you guys. Milana, the one that's on you, I doubt an 11 hits.
No.
Birdie, the two that are on you, are going to attack. 19 and 12.
What? Okay, the 19 hits.
So you're going to take a total... So you're going to take 2 slashing damage and 4 fire damage. So a total of 6.
What?
I just healed that for you.
Sir Nunos, you're going to get attacked twice. 21 and 16.
Well, damn it. Yes.
You're going to go ahead and take 6 damage as well.
Damn it.
And an extra... 5.
Oh, they decided to hit me hard.
And Bale, a 14 and an 18.
We'll both miss.
Oh, wow. Okay. So back to the top. Bale, please hit something.
Please hit something. I'm actually going to roll my dice this time and not rely on D&D. 15.
That hits.
4. 8 damage.
All right. Bale is on the scoreboard.
Woo! And I'll bonus action spit in his face.
Cool.
Did you add your extra enlarge damage?
Oh, that's a D4, right? I did not.
Add it.
You have an extra D4.
12 damage total. Adds 4.
Woo! Nice. Next up is Sir Nunos. There's 2 of them on you.
And they hurt me hard. Is it my turn?
It is your turn.
Then, very well. I shall choose. This is we turned a corner, as I recall, and this is a large room?
Yes.
Is there a space without Memphis immediately next to me?
There is, yes. To the south.
Then I flee as fast as I can to that corner.
Okay, you'll take 2 attacks of opportunity.
What about a full retreat?
Oh, never mind. If you're going to do that, that's okay.
Yes. Flee like a whatever that's called. Someone without courage. A coward!
All right.
No courage.
Coward. Birdie, your turn.
Dope, dope. What we're going to do is the exact same thing we did before, because I am nothing but consistent. Okay. The first one. Oh, how does a 10 do?
It hits.
Oh, they're weak. I like that.
Oh, they're weak.
and 19.
You hit as well.
Heck yeah. I assumed, but sometimes you don't know. Some of them are weak, some of them aren't.
Nice little lesson for people watching. Never give up on a roll. You'd be surprised.
A 7 to hit for damage for the first one.
Okay.
I give up.
And the second one's going to take... Oh, also a 7. Like I said, consistency.
So they're both going to explode after you attack them. So give me a dexterity saving throw.
13.
That passes. So with their explosion, it doesn't hit you all the way, but oh shit. You're going to take 5 damage.
But what the heck? Why were mine so much more powerful than the other ones?
Because I rolled 5 and a 7 compared to the 1s and 3s I've been rolling earlier.
Because, Liz, you're obviously a much bigger target and therefore must have more damage.
It's because she has arms.
That is true.
They're prejudiced against
exactly.
Arms.
Once you get arms,
tiny and adorable.
They're prone to bend.
They see the giant hammer I have.
All right. Speaking of tiny, it is now Milana's turn.
I smack this one. Let's see if I can send him flying. For a 18.
That hits.
And then I would like to use one of my new feet by sending him flying 5 feet.
Oh, nice.
Let me get this straight. Yeah. You're trying to send a monster made out of steam flying.
Yes. Well, that's a sad damage roll.
Dungeons and Dragons, ladies and gentlemen. Physics does not exist.
Physics doesn't exist in my real world, so I don't know what your problem is.
Physics? I'm not a gym leader from Pokemon.
That's 5 damage.
Okay.
I rolled 2 ones.
Ooh, ouch.
Yeah, and then I want him to move fly 5 feet from me.
Okay.
To an unoccupied space.
He gets knocked back, but he's gonna come back again.
Of course he is.
And he's gonna go and try to slice you.
No.
4 probably doesn't hit.
No.
The 2 that are left on bail. A 6 and a 14.
Nope.
The other 2 that were running away from Sununus was running away for, they're gonna try to attack you. A 4 and a 5.
Yes!
And before we continue on, thank you, Zach Standley, for your follow. We appreciate it.
Hooray for Zach Standley! Just so you know, he is the Zodiac Killer.
Oh, Ted Cruz.
Oh, I thought that was Ted Cruz.
Let's not go there. But good news, we're at 46 followers, 4 more followers, and you all get a magic item for free.
Hooray!
Including
you guys watching.
Let Milana have a magic item!
If 4 people, this not only goes for the players, but show your DM this video when it comes out on YouTube. If they do get a magic item, I'm giving you a magic item because they may be your DM. I'm your DM too. So, DM approved.
Yeah, I'm not showing this to my players at all. This is not allowed. No.
The other
just giving away magic items to other Dungeon Masters
double the amount
players?
Of items.
Every
wait,
game
Efren, does this mean if we get to 50 followers, does Cassiopeia from last night get a magic item?
That is a technicality, but you're playing.
That is what he's
so,
saying.
I don't know. We'll see.
Loophole.
Back to the top. It is Bale's turn.
All the D&D players.
Hooray for me, of course. Hooray for Zach Standley. We will sing songs. Maybe a pirate sea shanty.
I thought you were saying Prozac Stan Lee, and I was like, that's the coolest name I've ever heard.
Maybe he is a pro. I don't know.
Prozac. That's what it means.
Long sword swipe.
Go for it.
18 to hit.
18 hits.
Yep. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Rolling a d4. 9, 10, 11 damage total adding my dueling bonus.
That one is destroyed, and it blows up on you. So give me a dexterity saving throw.
A 1. Not natural, but a 1.
Okay. You're going to take 6 fire damage from that.
Not project. No, go away, bud.
You have one more person on you. It is now Sir Nunos, your turn.
Hooray! I load another rock into my sling, and I let it fly across the room. Does a 17 hit?
17 does hit, yes.
Hooray! That's 6 damage to them.
6 damage to each of them? Or one of them?
Just the one, I'm sorry. Just the one, the last one to have hit Bear.
All right. Next up.
You want the one to blow up on me too? What the hell, man?
Well, there's 2 on you, Sir Nunos, so you have to attack one of them.
They came to me?
Yeah. They followed you.
I thought they went to Bear.
Nope.
I don't care. They get attacks of opportunity if I use ranged melee weapons, yes?
No, you just get... I don't think you can because they're too much in your face.
Okay, so I guess that's when I daydreamed before I realized, oh my, they're in front of me. And I just put my head down and try to hit him as hard as I can. Should I roll again or just with the same one?
I'll just take the 6 damage for it.
That would be 2 damage.
You want to
strength
take
versus dex damage.
All right. You'll have 2 damage instead.
Perfect.
All right. Next up is Birdie. So Bale has 1 person. Milana has 1 person. Sir Nunos has 2 people on him.
I'm going to help out Sir Nunos because I don't know what's going on over there, but it's not attacking. So I'm going to go over there. I'm going to do what I've been doing to mine because it worked out pretty well. And I'm gonna hit out the first one with a nat 1.
Uh oh, hold on.
Oh no!
Our first nat 1 in battle. What happens to you?
Nothing.
Let's find out. Oh, something happens.
Oh, I get $1 million cash.
Fall on me. So that's roughly about 100 pounds falling on
you. Oh, good. The fuck!
I died doing what I love.
Oh god.
So, okay, nothing too bad. This one's actually not that bad for you. So, as you go in for a melee attack, you actually kind of just like slice and kind of take 5 feet away from them. You totally miss, and you're further away from them. So you just stumble on your feet.
Damn.
Hey, Birdie, you have legs too!
What? I'm confusion.
You have 1 more attack. You can still move up.
I use my other attack again.
Go for it.
Oh, this one's a little bit better. This one's a 19.
Okay, that hits.
Okay. Let's see. Ooh, it's going to be 10 damage.
10 damage. All right, cool. So next up is Milana.
I'm going after him again!
All right.
For a 11.
Hits.
Oh, it doesn't take much to hit these guys.
Ooh, goody. That will be 11 damage.
Cool. It is their turn.
I want to shove him 5 feet away again.
Does that? Moves back up to you?
I'm just going to keep sending him flying. Like, ah!
All right.
It's like he's on a bungee cord, so I'm just like, you know those paddle balls?
Yeah.
That's pretty much what I'm doing, it looks like.
Does a 17 hit you, Milana?
Oh, it does.
All right.
Barely.
You're going to take a total of 4 damage.
I don't.
Sir Nunos, you're going to take 1 attack, and Birdie, you're going to take 1 attack.
What?
So, Sir Nunos, I believe a 10 probably doesn't hit you.
No!
Neither do you, Birdie.
Mm-mm.
And finally, an attack to Bale is going to be a 15.
Negative.
All right. Bale, back to you.
We're going to go ahead and swing at the one that's still alive in front of me.
All right.
The for 7.
God, you rolled a 7?
Yep.
Jeez, dude.
Wait a second. Was that damage or to hit?
To hit.
Can we get a... God! Can we, in the chat, can we get a bless the dice going?
bless the dice.
Maybe that might help him next turn.
Yeah.
Sir Nuno, it's your turn.
Oh my god.
All right, I choose to sidestep in a way that I get a little further away from the Memphit attacking Birdie Cage, and then I will come. I will gyrle myself a little hop and come down upon the offending Memphit, kind of like unto a goat would. And yes, I got a 17 to hit.
All right, that hits.
And 1 damage.
Okay.
What?
So in the chat, we got 2 bless emojis and a blessed baby Jesus. So
I'm hoping to be blessed.
No, I'm pretty sure that blessed baby Jesus. It's just me. I'm tiny. Please, it's me. I'm baby.
Blessed little Milana.
It's wow. Birdie's turn.
I am blessed. These poor people listening to us are just like, what is happening to them tonight? It's like, it's called We Have No Clue.
So, Birdie, your turn.
Great. I'm going to look at Sir Nunes and go, what the heck, man? And then I'm going to do my attack again.
Hey, he's doing better than me. I can't even hit him, and they're made of steam.
Like, I feel like
only going straight through him.
You already. The first one's going to go with a 15 to hit.
Oh, yeah.
The second one's going to be, 23.
Oh, yeah.
Sweet. So the first one, I'll use the first one's dice. Oh, that's going to be 11 damage.
That one is destroyed and burst. So Sir Nunes and Birdie, give me a dexterity saving throw.
I specifically said I stepped away from that correct. One.
That is true. That you're.
Hooray!
I'm angry because I just fought in a state for him. He wanted to take the damage for me. Whatever.
We don't both need the damage.
20. It's a 20.
Okay, so you only take 3 damage.
Why do they have so much damage?
Because, fuck you, that's why?
Oh. Okay, and then the second one's going to take... 2 and 5 is 7 damage.
All right. Milana, your turn.
Gonna smash him again. I'm not quite angry because I have no clue what's going on with these tiny things. 15.
Cool. You do damage.
I do damage. Oh, good. 10 damage.
All right. Give me a dexterity saving throw.
No.
As it blows up.
I send him flying into a wall.
Oh, that's right. You do have that feat, so you would actually send it backwards as it blows up. So it wouldn't hit you.
I send him flying.
Now the Mephit's turn. But seeing that they're now outnumbered. They're outnumbered. They kind of fade away into the steam. The battle is over.
That was weird.
Are they gone or
they're gone.
Are they coming back as one?
The mega
giant steam
and a giant steam elemental appears.
That was weird. I'm
still not gonna be able to touch you.
I don't really get it. They don't do a whole lot of damage.
Looking at the size of my body and seeing that I'm now the size of a normal human man, Sir Nuno's, how long is this going to last?
Well, it's I think a minute until I stop concentrating.
He can't
hit? Pretty soon. Would you like for it to end now?
How long does it have left on it? What's the about an hour?
We probably did like 6 rounds there. So another 30 seconds, I think.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I'm not too worried about it. Yeah, just go ahead, and pop it down now. Let's just end it. That'll last like
according
an hour.
To Hundo, 4 to 6 hours. If it lasts longer, call your doctor.
I need to go find another optoma cleric.
No, you need actually a different cleric this time.
Because you clearly can't see your target.
You probably should go back. I think you're still blind.
I'm still a little blind.
Also, you guys might have not taken a lot of damage, but they fucked me up.
I will put my hand upon Birdie Cage and heal her for seven total health back.
Sweet, I'm only kind of fucked up now.
Is there anything you want to do in this room before you move on?
Oh, is there something shiny around here?
Yeah, give me a perception.
Shiny? Ooh, nat 20!
Oh, yeah, so you find something like this little clump in the corner. Do you go over to it?
I go touch it.
You notice it's a lucky rabbit's foot. Once per day, it gives you an extra 5 feet of jump. Or you could sell it for 28 gold.
Ooh. It's for a rabbit. Is it okay?
Well, no, it was okay.
A lucky rabbit's foot. Got it.
I'm going to take my backpack off and rummage through it and pull out a horn of wine and also a canteen of water. I'm going to I have a string that is underneath wax paper that is put over it. So I pull the string and it just peels the layer off, and I peel it up. I take a sip, pour some out for the
to your fallen friends, Memphit fellows.
And then anyone want some?
He just poured one out for the
homies. Ooh, is that juice?
Here you are, you little one.
And then I will open the canteen, take a swig, and then pour half of it out on the floor.
And to replenish your lost reserves.
And then put these away and continue on.
So just a reminder, Sir Nunos just gave a child alcohol.
You don't seem to understand. Where I'm from, you drink alcohol always. Every day
didn't care.
Since you were born.
You
and that means that the
womb.
Mother's milk is also alcohol. So everyone always is drinking.
I'm going to drink the wine.
All right. Give me a con save real quick.
Oh, good. You mean the barbarian has to give a con save?
I've seen it fail before.
This is true, but not this time because that's a non-natural 20.
All right. So you're like, you've got to feel like, I have harder before.
The fairies have better.
I believe it. Let me have it. I may reuse that for another wine someday.
I give it back.
All right.
The fairies got better wine.
What would you like
they
to
got
do?
This really good one called whiskey.
I think I've had that one. Let's move on. Is there another door or just hallway in front of us?
Hallway. So as you go into the next room, it opens up to an even bigger room. You see purple light flickering as you enter this room. You notice that this light comes from a stone. The room has puddles of stagnant water that smell horrid. There's two exits in this room. To the left leads to a wet hallway. To the right, the pathway is dry.
Oh.
There's purple light.
Coming from a stone.
I want to go see that.
Is that the soul stone or is that like the...
No, that's power.
Oh, power is purple. Soul is orange.
Soul was orange.
I'm going to move towards this glowing ember and knowledge arcana upon it.
So you and Milana...
Natural 20 plus 8.
You and Milana go up to it and then you notice that... this stone is like a message stone that carries a message that some people like would inbound a message onto to whoever picks it up.
I don't think I can reach it.
You can't get onto your knee and pick it up.
Oh, wait, is it on the ground?
Yeah, it's on the ground.
Oh, I thought it was on like a pedestal. It's like, I can't reach. No. Okay,
it's
no.
On the floor.
There's funny things that happen to your vision when you're drunk, little one.
My knees don't bend.
My knees don't bend. I touch it.
All right, so you get a message from it. A great evil has come upon our land. To any who receive this message, please come to our aid.
It's saying evil! Help!
Did they say who it was?
No.
Well, if they leave their name.
I hand it to Sir Nunos. Here you go.
Do I get the same message?
No.
I'm sorry, little one, but it appears that you are the only one that received the message.
That's
you are the only one that can lead us forward.
It's that a great evil has
come to our land. To any who receive this message, please come to our aid.
Know who it is?
Nope. You just got this message.
Okay, Milana, I need you to, as we continue forward, concentrate on any pull that feels like it's coming from within your body. And let me know if you feel like you have a desire to go north or east or down that hallway.
Fairies!
Let's go!
So which
do I
go?
Feel any pull to go somewhere?
No.
No, nothing.
Go and get a perception or investigate.
Oh, which one's better? Ooh, investigation's better. That is another natural 20.
Ooh, nice. So you know,
I love these blood dice.
The wet hallway probably leads to deeper and deeper into the sewers. Just kind of just like looking how everything is. The other one is just dry. Based on everything you've been kind of seeing down here, you get an idea that if we want to go deeper into the sewers, left will probably be your better choice.
Left is the what one?
Sewers. Deeper sewers. Into sewers.
Okay. And I tell the party that. Mostly right. Because I've already forgotten what you told me.
Okay.
Luckily, I rolled a non-natural 20, and I understood much the same. Let's go deep!
Wait, is that the one that there's, like, water? Or is that the one that there's, like, not water?
It has water.
It's water. We're going deeper into the shit!
I'd like to fold my legs in and float down the water like a duck.
Okay.
Do you really want to do that?
Birdie is an aircopter, so I'm going to allow it.
Birdie, do you have a... What color are your feathers?
I
don't know.
It's dirty now.
It's like a urine yellow. That's not...
I think it's brown now.
Well... Okay.
Forward!
To those watching, no, we're not above potty humor. It will happen.
Oh, we are far below potty humor.
So you go down this hallway and you discover there's a T intersection. There's to the right or to the left. Where would you like to go?
I will make an investigation to see if there was any amount of traffic for 16.
Okay, so you notice down to the right, it looks like a whole bunch, an area full of, like, crates and barrels. To the left leads down deeper into a hallway.
If anyone cares, there might be loot that you could find in a sewer. I don't know. But this way's too deeper within. That's my way. And I start.
Loot in a sewer?
That's my thoughts. I'm going to just leave it.
And
What's in the barrels?
I'll start moving downwards.
So can I go barrel and like kick it open?
Sure.
Cool.
So you go over to one of the barrels, you kick it open, you kick it, and you feel like it's pretty heavy, and like there's something inside this barrel.
Okay, I'm gonna open the barrel.
Unfortunately, you cannot open the barrel, but there is an inscription on top of the barrel.
Can I read it?
Sure. I can be tall, but beyond hips never placed. Through empty I rest, traveling fools to my taste. To keep me at home is not but a waste.
No.
Okay, hold on. Sorry, one more time. I can be tall.
I can be tall, but beyond hips never placed.
Beyond hits?
Beyond hips. H-I-P-S.
As if hips don't lie?
Though empty I rest, traveling fools to my taste.
Traveling fools or
full? F-U-L-L.
I want to make sure fools to my
taste. Sounds like a sheath.
To keep me at home is not but a waste.
It sounds like a a sheath.
Do you say sheath?
Sure.
I said sheath from down the hallway.
But I'll say I don't know what this is. I was just writing down for note purposes. I'm with Sir Nudos trying to make sure he stays safe where he's at. So
it doesn't open.
It doesn't open.
When you say sheath, it doesn't open.
It's tall. You don't want to keep it at home. It doesn't go past your hips.
Shakira!
I was going to say Shakira, because her hips don't lie.
I'm seeing as Milana and Birdie haven't made their way to us, I'm going to make my way and drag Sir Nunos back so he stays safe.
You don't need to drag, and it's all of 30 feet.
Because they don't have your hips, and you don't want to leave them at home.
What are we talking about? What's going on here?
Pants. Oh, wait, no, there's a riddle.
There's a riddle, okay.
Open the barrel.
I take a look at the barrel and obviously read the riddle.
I'll read it one more time for the audience. I can be tall, but beyond hips never placed. Though empty I rest, traveling fools to my taste. To keep me at home is not but a waste. If anyone in the chat can solve this, I will give you a magic item. You tell your DM about this. and I will make sure you get a magic item.
Is it a belt?
It also, I think more maybe a canteen or water skin. Container.
Both of those answers are incorrect.
Ah, shit.
A waste?
There were three answers there. There was belt, canteen, and water skin.
None of them are correct.
Okay.
Waste.
Hey, waste. You want to help me with a riddle here?
Your hip bones.
Huh?
Are you asking your wife to help you?
She came in the room. So yes, I'm not. She'll be part of the audience. She's
okay.
Yeah, hold on. Let me call my mom.
But beyond hips never placed, though empty I rest. Traveling fools to my riddles. Taste.
We're good. Don't
to
worry.
Keep
well,
me at
I'm
home
not
is not
here.
But a waste. I mean, Birdie, if your mom can solve this,
your mom gets a magic item.
Your mom gets a magic item.
She's gonna think it's like a key to a house that I can move into instead of hers, but the stomach.
Be tall.
Nope.
And this is written on a barrel.
It's on a barrel.
What about like a bladder?
Nope.
Oh.
I rest traveling fools. That's the part that throws me off. Traveling fools to my taste. That just to keep me at home is not but a waste. This is like a puzzle for kindergartners that we're going to spend 4 hours trying to figure out.
The my traveling full is a waste part is what really made me think that it was a sword sheath.
Traveling full all is right. To my taste.
Who's going to get it first? The adventurers? The Twitch chat?
Or you
Bale's wife? Or Birdie's mom?
Can I roll history from when I was with the fairies? Maybe they told me a riddle.
Hold on. Let me... Hey, Mom.
No.
He's ignoring me on purpose, I think. He's right outside the door.
I'm on a 22 for history.
Nothing came up.
No. They wouldn't know what this is, actually.
Oh, those fairies have let me down for the first time.
So, for those in the chat, make sure you support your local gaming store. Whether you play D&D.
Is it a sock?
Pokemon, Magic. What was that?
A sock?
No, but I will say this. You are close.
A shoe?
You're close.
Waiters for fishing.
Pants? I already said pants.
It's not pants.
Underwear.
Waiters. Those are the ones.
Huh. Stock shoes, stockings.
Nope.
Is it suspenders?
No.
Damn it. FBI rest, traveling fool, fools. Traveling
fools. Oh, a cell phone.
What was that?
A cell phone?
Specifically the battery.
So Bale's answer of shoes and socks are very close.
Oh, gloves.
No.
No, nothing not above hips, so it has to be on the feet.
A cod piece.
I'm thinking like, so obviously.
A jock strap.
A flip flop.
No. Sandal.
Gears?
Cross.
That's what I meant.
Oh. Instead
of the exact same. A gator's the thing that goes around the neck.
Why? Like, what else? So, pants out, socks out, shoes out, boots, but if shoes don't work, I don't see boots working.
A dress, a skirt.
Is that your answer?
High boots. Heels
are different I from shoes.
Boots. So, when you say boots, the barrel opens, and inside is a man who looks up, and you can see him like,
there's a man
trying to trying to see what's out there. Who's there?
No one.
I cast light right in my hand, right above the barrel, so that it takes him even longer to
blind the man inside a barrel.
I mean, it won't blind him; just a little like momentary. You can't see.
You immediately see that he blocks his eyes. He's breathing. He's pretty heavy as he's inside this barrel, and he looks kind of thin.
Who are you? And why are you inside a barrel in a sewer?
Is that where I am? Sorry, he starts getting up very slowly, puts his hands up.
Stop, wait.
He's looking down. Giles Helmer. That's my name.
That's a nerd name.
Oh well.
How dressed I'll just go is back Giles into my Helmer? Barrel.
Sounds good.
Why were you in a barrel?
They stuffed me in here.
They
you were trying to recreate the Hobbit?
The Marauders, a bunch of...
Where?
They were a bunch of orcs, mainly run by orcs. I had to work with them for a while, but after I refused, they stuffed me in the barrel and they sent me onward.
Where did they send you from? Do you remember where you were?
I can't recall. I do remember...
Have you forgotten... All that was before this barrel?
Where are we, by the way?
A cave.
We are
in a sewer.
In the city of Coastone.
The capital of Ice Creamtopia.
You're telling me I'm across the sea?
Maybe.
You said you didn't know where you were from.
Because I haven't given it a name yet.
What?
Well, this makes sense. I have been there before.
I thought that was actually good. I have a new
one. The other crates and barrels, do they have riddles on them?
No, a lot of them are kind of smashed. You see the like just a bunch of like just mundane gear.
I smash it more because it's for the Marauders.
Barrel boy Giles, I must ask you another question.
Yes.
What do you intend to do with the rest of your life?
The whole reason why I worked for them was to pay to make sure my family can keep living. I didn't want them to pick off scraps anymore.
As soon as I hear him say he worked for the Marauders, I'm already like placing myself in between him and Milana.
Oh, I'm in the background smashing the other crates and barrels.
I'm standing between them currently.
What? Yeah, sorry.
I'm not even paying attention to him. I'm smashing crates and barrels because he said they were Marauders stuff.
I wasn't a fighter.
What are you good at? What are your skills?
I was a pretty decent locksmith.
Interesting.
I'm a good locksmith. I have a hammer.
Listen, if you stick with me, I've got a crew that I think you'd fit right into.
What?
Paid good gold. Just make it through this little sewer adventure of ours, and I'll get you a job, man.
Wait, why did the Marauders need a locksmith?
He kind of points out to the gear. Well, they needed to break into a couple of places.
Oh, so you broke into places. That's illegal.
I know. I'm not proud of it, but
I couldn't see my child. If no one lives there, it's not a crime.
I couldn't see my children starve again. At this point,
I pulled out my tinderbox, and I'm starting to light them on fire.
You're lighting it on fire. Okay.
So listen. Actually,
Before I get too deep into trying to hire this guy, what is it to like decide how honest they're being?
Insight.
When he's describing himself as a locksmith and being from this faraway unknown land that we just don't quite know how to pronounce yet, I roll a 22 on insight.
You know he's telling the truth. You know, based on his mannerisms, his story checks out. Like, he has nothing to hide.
This is why you live!
How many kids?
You just stay a little back from us. Keep an eye out. Stay alive. And I'll get you money to keep your family alive. If they still live.
Jeez.
Thank you?
Thank you?
He says with a question mark.
Oof.
I'll place my arm inside the barrel and use it to help pull him out.
He's very skinny, very thin, but he's able to kind of boost himself up.
While he's passing me, I'm going to whisper in his ear, don't bring up working for the Marauders again around the little one. She's likely to bash out your kneecaps.
I should probably do it anyway.
True, but...
Very good.
Just... mentioning that.
And to answer bird person.
But hey! Racist.
I have two children, a son and a daughter.
Wow. I feel like for crime you should have at least five.
We're trying.
For us.
Need three more. I've sufficiently destroyed the Marauder's stuff now.
So I'm going to take the barrel lid and put it back on and see if I can... Is it magically sealed back on?
Yeah, it locks back up. As soon as you put it back on, it locks.
Perfect. Giles, listen. You get this barrel brought out with us and these two gold... Well, here's the two gold regardless, but get the barrel out if you can.
Okay, he asks which way is out.
Oh, shit.
Well... I mean, you could follow slightly uphill, or you could hide inside the barrel and we could come back and get you later, or you could follow us.
I'll wait right here.
Do you want to be back inside the barrel?
No.
All right, just in case, before we go, boot. No, what was it?
Boot.
Okay, the lid comes up and it's open in case of emergency.
Okay.
Let's go!
Well, wait, Giles, are you good at fighting?
No. I was never an infantryman.
Well, do you know how to, like, hit people with pointy things?
No.
You really can't even... You don't know, like, the basics of shivving?
No.
What?
I only joined so I can get money. The only skill I had to my name was unlocking locks.
Giles, I've got a secret for you. Next time you see a man that tries to kill you or put you in a barrel, take any sharp object, look at his belly button, and pretend that it is a keyhole. Take the sharp object, pretending it is a key, and insert, twist, and remove. Do that over and over until job complete.
I've lost interest. I'm now wandering down the left hallway.
Let's go!
Will do. So he's going to stay behind. You can come back and get him later.
This man can't stab things.
Well, you never asked about his background, other than, can you stab? I'm like, no, he is a peaceful man.
But that doesn't mean you can't stab things. Listen, even if you were like, I don't know, a baby, you could stab something.
Don't know what kind of babies you hang around, but babies don't tend to stab people.
Their nails? They are sharp.
They're real sharp.
So, baby can stab. So you continue down the hallway. This place invokes a very unsettling mood. The air is stagnant and reeks of decay. On the floor, you see a body of a lone gnome face up near a small pool of water.
Uh-oh.
On its forehead has been branded with the symbol of chaos and marauders.
I'll pop a divine sense again.
Okay.
Celestial fiend undead within 60 feet.
Nothing. So is he on his back or on his front?
He's like laying on his back. His eyes are kind of rolled back. And you can
so his eyes are open?
Yeah.
I want to close them and then say, I'm sorry.
Okay. His eyes are now closed.
I'm going to investigate the body and see if maybe he is a member of the Gnomes Guild or any other identifying marks for 15.
You notice that he was probably like a journeyman, someone who came down here to clean the sewers and whatnot, work on the pipes. Poor based lad. On his uniform and what he's wearing.
Can I check to see if he has anything on him, like physically items?
Yeah, sure. So other than like you see like some smithing tools that he was going to be working on down here. But that's kind of it.
No keyring?
No.
Perfect.
Anything else?
Okay.
You continue no. on?
I can see you!
I am ready. Well.
I've left.
What killed the man?
As you look around, you see there's a bunch of stabbing, a lot of bludgeoning damage, just a lot of, like, he's messed up. Like, you just see, like, he just took a number.
Whoever. Either this was one very single individual, or a whole mob smashing upon this one small man.
Well, it was stabbing and...
You can smash with an... I don't care, we're not going to get into the physics of weapons.
Are you sure it's not a bludgeoning, slashing, and piercing axe?
Yeah, that's what I was going to say. This sounds like one axe.
I was going to say with a sword, but whatever.
I mean, you can bludgeon with a sword. You take the hilt and smash it with the hilt.
Slap them with the side? That's it
really
hurts?
To catch the viewers wait, which up, side? We've had a long discussion. A long discussion whether or not an axe can also be a stabbing weapon. We've and had many tried photo evidence axe that it can.
Roll the natural one.
So,
can we? Let's continue on. Okay. Let's keep going.
The next room is filled with hundreds of rat skulls covered in dust, that are piled haphazardly on the floor. The ground rumbles and the mound of skull rats loosens up, enough of them to reveal a couple of other humanoid skulls.
Oh.
Is there anything else you do in this room?
Why was it rumbling?
You just felt like a vibration, just like kind of shake.
Great. I am going to do a knowledge nature to determine what kind of humanoids those were for 17.
Okay, you notice they're a bit mainly gnomes and dwarves.
Are there any live rats?
Go and give me perception. And, Sir Nunez, also give me perception since you're looking at the skull.
12.
You don't find any rats here.
19!
You notice that one of the humanoid skull has, both of its eye sockets each have a large emerald resting in them.
Oh, that's a trap for sure.
Birdie, go get those emeralds.
Emeralds, because I like money.
This appears to be a sweet treat of jewels in eyes of a skull, but I feel like something is amiss.
I take them. I love it.
What's your alignment?
Good.
Okay.
Oh, it's
good.
Not anymore.
So, yeah. Go and give me an Arcana check on these.
Oh, shoot. Hold on. Oh, mine's not gonna be good. Okay, hold on.
I got a 21. So a natural 20 on the Arcana check.
I got a 12.
Oh, natural 20?
7.
Yeah.
You know these are talismans of pure good.
Brilliant.
What's that mean?
So, must require an attunement by a creature of good alignment. If held by anything that's not good, the holder will take 6d6 radiant damage.
Oof.
No. 8d6 radiant damage.
Damn.
The talisman is a mighty symbol of goodness. A creature that is neither good nor evil. Okay, if they're neutral, they take 66. If they're evil, they take 86. If you are a good cleric or paladin, you can use a talisman as a holy symbol, and you gain +2 bonus to your spell attack rolls while you wear or hold it. The talisman has 7 charges. If you're wearing it or holding it, you can use an action to expend 1 charge. From it, you choose 1 creature you can see on the ground within 120 feet. If the target is an evil alignment, a flaming fissure opens under it. The target must exceed a DC 20 dexterity saving throw or fall into the fissure and be destroyed, leaving no remains. The fissure then closes, leaving no trace of its existence. Damn. When you expend the last charge, the talisman disperses into motes of golden light and is destroyed.
This is fun.
Can it do all? Can it do the whole fissure thing without being a cleric or paladin?
Yes, it can.
Okay, I'm good. One of you can have that firestone.
May I take that firestone? Because
there was two of them, right?
There was two of them.
There's two.
Yeah, and I can use it as a spellcasting focus.
You can have one, yeah.
Okay.
Buddy, you picked it up.
What is? It's amazing. You have a good aligned character.
For once, yeah.
And you haven't done anything to ruin that good alignment in, what, the first episode?
Yet, yes. We're still waiting.
I'm pretty sure you're going to
yeah,
be...
Yeah, I will send it to you. I'll send it in the group chat real quick. I'll just give you the website.
This is great.
Yeah, when I was making these dungeons, I rolled, and this was the item that popped up. So, you're welcome.
Good. But there's two of them?
There's two of them.
Oh, sweet.
Yeah, because most skulls have two eyes.
I'm going to take the second one, just because we can.
Efren, is there multiple ways out of this, or is it kind of an opening to go back into a hallway? What's the situation here?
You see down the hallway, continue in, it does open up into a bigger room.
Okay.
I would like to request a short rest real quick.
No.
I need to attune this item to me, so either we short rest or I and whoever else has a second one don't get to use it.
Dope. Let's short rest it up.
I start juggling rat skulls.
Okay. I concentrate on my daily spells.
So if you want to heal, now would be a good time.
I do. I've gained all my health points back.
All right.
I'm back full health, guys.
So let me know when you all are finished so we can continue on.
So added that. Was it 1d10 for that? Let's roll that real quick. Is it so short rest? Is it d10 plus con modifier or just d10?
Plus con.
Yeah. Okay, so heal for 4. Woo! That was a horrible roll.
Bless the dice.
There is no blessing of the dice tonight. It is only
apparently
dead.
Not. It's been horrible. Horrible for me. But I am... do I get anything else with my short rest? Let's check. I did one roll. Take short rest.
Do I get a rage back with that, or is that after a long rest?
I think you do get your rages back after a short rest.
Oh, great. I have all 3 back.
Do you? I thought it was after a long rest.
I think it was a long rest.
Yeah.
I don't really care. I still have 2 if I don't get it back.
Check it right now. Rage.
I break everything. Stab it.
Long rest before you can rage again. Rages are
let life. Us move towards the opening of
that's,
this hallway.
Is the thing that made the mound of skulls vibrate, is it moving?
No, it just kind of collapsed on its own.
I'm going to say yes, in the last 10 minutes, has anything happened?
No, nothing else happened.
Okay.
As we're leaving, Efren, Yes. I'm going to be, I'm going to say, oh, hold on a second. I need to go wee. And I'm going to run back the way we came. And then what I'm actually going to do is I'm going to cast a cantrip, and it's going to make the skull pile, what's left of it, just rumble a little bit as well.
You guys see the skull pile rumble.
Why is it rumbling?
And that's all. We can continue.
All right. Rumble. So it opens up into a big, vast room. You see flowing water that probably leads out to the ocean. You see all these different pipes, all these different tunnels that lead in and out of the sewage system. Flowing water, no longer stagnant water. It smells as like kind of a bit salty in terms of the oceans nearby. In this room, you see an orc war chief and two orcs wearing marauder and chaos symbols on them. As they approach you, they notice that you are not part of their team.
I rage.
Go ahead and roll initiative.
Oh, I rage. I'm going for that chieftain.
Why do I have amazing initiative rolls and sucky everything else?
Wow.
Because they were blessed.
These are blessed, but everything else isn't.
All right, so 20 or higher?
No.
Nope.
15 or higher?
16.
19.
All right. 10 or higher? 5 or higher?
8.
Oh.
What'd you get, Birdie?
An 8.
Ooh.
Who has a higher dex?
Birdie.
Oh, God. This is my dex. Oh, 13.
You have a 13 for dex? I got you beat.
All right.
I've got 16, I think.
We should have gone off the
show. No, I'm at 18 because of my plus one. That's right. It was 17.
All right. What? So we got a orc war chief and two orcs backing them up. Milana, you're first.
Oh, I'm raging. Go so let's it. See what wild magic we get up.
Ooh,
it's the bolt of light.
All right, what does that do?
A bolt of light shoots from my chest. Another creature of your choice that I can see within 30 feet must succeed on a constitution saving throw or take 1d6 radiant damage and be blinded until my next turn. Until my rage ends, I can use it again on each of my turns as a bonus action.
Nice. Well, I got a natural 20.
No, motherfuck. Well, I'll get you next time. It's okay. I'm going to attack him, though, with my maul. All
right, go for it. You go after the big chief?
Oh, I do go after the big chief. Of course I'm going after him. Let's see. That would be a... Ooh, both good rolls, because I didn't reckless attack. 21.
Oh, yeah, that hits.
Good. And that will be 14 damage.
Oof.
Right to the kneecaps.
Ooh.
The war chief takes a mighty blow to the kneecaps. He responds, ow, honestly, who hits the kneecaps?
I do!
All right, Bale, your turn.
I'm going to pop my channel divinity for conquering presence, and all three orcs need to make me a wisdom saving throw with a DC of 13, please.
All right. The war chief, 17. One of the orcs, 8. The other orc, 8.
So the two non-boss orcs are frightened of me and spend their turns running away from me until he no longer can.
Oh, wow.
I'm going to move forward by 25 feet.
Go for it.
That was my action, though. Excuse me. The talisman itself doesn't state whether using it is an action or bonus action.
It's an action. It would be an action. Expending charge. Okay, so let me
put that down. Let me edit so I can know that.
Seven charges. Holding it. You can use... Oh, use an... It does say that. Sorry. Use an action to expend. Bonus action. I'm going to cast Divine Favor on my weapon.
All right. Next
and time. Oh. That will be it for me.
Sir Nunos, your turn.
Very good. I choose... to do that same action that I was so excited for earlier, I cast Entangle.
Okay.
How many of them could I get with that 20-foot cube of spider webs?
I'd recommend not doing that, because if you do anything to break the frighten on the other two, we're fighting three people.
I thought we already were.
I frightened the other two.
Two of them are going to run away on their turn.
Fair. So they're very close to each other. Fine. I won't do anything cool. I don't drop my walking stick and pull out my crossbow and attempt it at a shot. That's 16 to hit.
That's assuming to the war chief, the one that's not Brian.
The one that is actively engaged.
That hits.
Perfect. That currently has his kneecap hurting.
That's a 9 damage.
9 damage, all right. Next up, Birdie.
Sweet. So I'm going to get out my great axe, my plus one great axe, and I'm going to cast my Blood Maledict. I'm going to...
I realized you said sweet, but I thought for sure you said tweet.
I'm going to tweet about this real quick.
You know Twitter?
I'm going to, it's just for birds. We just scream at each other in the trees. So I'm going to activate my Crimson Rite. So I just get an extra D4 of damage. That's lightning damage from my weapon. And I have to take damage real quick. Give me a second. Oh, shit. I took full damage. Okay, great. Good job, Birdie. You sure did damage. Okay. So I'm going to attack the big main guy with my great axe. For a 21.
That hits.
Perfect. No, I need D12. Okay. Okay, so he's going to take 11 regular damage and 4 lightning damage.
All right, so it's going to be his turn. He's going to go ahead and hit Milana and Birdie with his great axe.
Just be hilarious if he just picked up.
In one swing?
He has 2 attacks.
Oh.
So Milana, 19.
Yeah.
Birdie, 19 as well.
But I get a half it.
All right. So the damage you're going to take, Milana... be 20 damage. So half of that damage is 10. Birdie. Oh,
shit. 3.
Like 10 damage.
Not wrong. Not like 15 damage.
Okay.
It is now the orcs' turn that are feared. They start running away. Do they get to make another save?
At the end of their turns, they can make a save.
They move 30 feet away. First one, no. What was the save?
13.
One of them makes it and kind of shakes it off. So one of them will be coming back to battle.
Dang it.
It is now back to Milana.
Okay, great. He's now hit me, so I'm going to recklessly attack him because I'm even angrier now.
Nice.
Can he make a con save for me, please?
Oh, that's right. Okay.
Come on, man. Fine, the bolt of light doesn't hit him, but guess what? My maul just got a nat 20.
Your mic kind of dipped a little, so...
Oh, sorry. So he misses the bolt of radiant light, but I got a nat 20, so...
Oh, nice. So she got a nat 20. Let's see what...
The blood dice love me tonight. They want blood.
All right, let's see what specialty see stuff happens with you. So how I do critical hits is I roll a chart. Also, the first, so if you have a d12 to your crit, you get that full 12 and then you roll another. That's kind of how we play it. It's brought to one of our friends and we like that roll a lot. So table 39, you have melee. Oh, wait, hold on. Critical hits. Player critical hit. All right. So 78. With your crits, what happens is 38. What are you using, a maul? Is it slashing, piercing, bludgeoning?
Bludgeoning.
Oh, jeez.
Does he lose his legs? Does he lose his legs?
You're rolling 2d6s, right?
Yeah.
So roll another set of 2d6s and multiply that by 3. So you get your 12.
What the hell?
She got quadruple damage.
Jeez.
Okay.
Ah. I get to actually hit him. Come on, man.
Okay, let me have this right. So I have the full 12 from the crit.
So roll 2d6 again.
I get another roll from the normal damage, and then another roll?
No. So for that double, that other damage, multiply that by 3, and we'll add it on.
Oh, God.
Yes. Yeah.
Give me a moment to do some math.
Math is not our strong suit, and we love to play D&D.
Math is usually fine, but there's so many numbers jumping around that
if we were good at math, we'd be playing Pathfinder.
Hey! 53.
Jeez.
I rolled a 9. Oh, so gosh. 9 times 3 is 36.
9 times 3 is 27, plus 12 is 30.
Never mind. I did math wrong, because I was thinking of a different number. I was thinking of 12 for some reason.
He's gonna have to make a con save.
No. How much is the actual damage then?
Nothing.
27 plus 12 is 39.
44, because I still have
plus 5.
Yeah.
All right.
Oof. Still fucked on the damage.
That's a lot of damage, and because he failed his con save.
Now that's a lot of damage.
We don't have any flex tape, unfortunately.
What was that? He didn't make the con save?
On his next saving throws he has to do, he has disadvantage on them. For the next 6 rounds, he has disadvantage on any kind of saving throw.
No. So he might get hit with some radiant damage if he lives for me to hit him again.
Oh, snap. Okay. It is now Bale's turn.
You know, or
his kneecap is gone.
Oh yeah, he tore ACL, MCL, they're all gone.
That kneecap is just powder?
Pretty much.
Obviously he's an orc. Obviously he's a follower of chaos. So I'm gonna give this a shot. I'm gonna take out the talisman.
Okay.
And I want to expend a charge on the evil creature that is in front of me.
All right. So you see the floor beneath them open and split the ground. You see him immediately kind of fall and try to reach for the heavens as he tries to avoid. He has disadvantage, so he still has to roll for this.
Exactly.
Oh, he does not make it.
I want to
take
him!
You kind of see, like, these shadowy things grab him and drag him underneath, and the floor beneath him goes back to normal. The war chief is gone.
What?
And then, bonus action, if possible, intimidate. So, obviously, I know the other one is still frightened of me. The one that I know is not frightened is turn around. Intimidation check, and, like, unless you want to end up like your leader, you will turn and run now.
All right, you get advantage because, he just saw hell open.
Okay, that's advantage 17.
Okay, what did I get? He throws his axe down and he starts booking it. He leaves, and that's the end of battle. right where the gates of hell kind of opened, out came a little package that kind of shot back out.
Oh. Like little, I look at it because I'm still angry I didn't get the orc. Is it his head? Is it his head?
I don't know. It's a loot drop. You have to go check.
I'm looking.
Inside is a head and a +1 crossbow. Ooh. And 10 bolts. Each bolt has a funny little saying on it. Like, ow, this will sting. Ooh, that's got a hoit.
Ooh, that's got a hoit.
And 8 other phrases that you may add.
Did we go to someone. The chance?
Was that a light crossbow or a crossbow?
It's duck season.
Which one?
No, it's rabbit season.
Duck I think season. I can use both. I don't remember.
It's a crossbow. Whoever takes it.
I don't remember how that works.
Whether it's light or heavy, I'll let you know whatever weapon you could use. And
what's your class?
What?
What's the class? I can look real quick
for you. Oh! Birdie needs a bow.
I have a bow.
Oh, who didn't have a bow?
Oh, hold on.
Birdie has javelins.
I don't want one.
Oh, it turns out I have a crossbow.
I have javelins.
Me too.
I'll take the bow, but I think if anyone else wants it, they should. I'm not very good at this whole fighting thing.
So
wait, I thought it was a crossbow.
It's a crossbow.
Senior Sir Nunos, what are your classes again? If I remember, you said wizard cleric.
I'm a wizard cleric.
I think clerics get crossbows, but
Yes. Light crossbows, light crossbows. Okay, but cleric might.
It's his head that was brought in the box.
Yeah, it was also his head.
I smash it.
All right. It kind of spews everywhere.
I don't care. Yeah. He's with the marauders. He must die.
Is the crossbow a simple weapon?
Yeah.
Then you can use it.
I can use it because I'm a cleric.
All right, so let me go ahead and look up what crossbow. It'll be a light crossbow. +1 light crossbow.
Yeah, it would be light. It's not. Okay. Yeah.
So after the battle happens, you hear a huge explosion coming from the surface.
Ooh.
Multiple explosions and multiple things going on back at the surface top.
I turn to Bale because I'm sure
you need to make a way up top.
And go, why did you do that?
Look, we needed to kill him before he killed us.
Oh, all right. I was killing him, all right.
I'm sure you were, but he might have killed you first. You're welcome.
I wanted to cast a spell on him. I had one ready.
I'm going to take...
Yeah, man. Oh, shoot. He's a limp and red hair.
In the famous words of a State Farm commercial, you gotta be quicker than that.
Did his loincloth or whatever clothing he was wearing pop up with him?
No.
Damn it.
The mofo is gone.
So you see...
you do that on a man with red hair and a limp.
Can I just knock on the floor and be like, can you send the weapon he was using up?
No.
Dang it.
So you see, what's his name, run in. Giles Helmer walk in. Hey, there's an attack coming from above.
I figured as much. And I think... then we should probably get there as fast as possible.
And that's where we're going to end today's game. Awesome. So from that, you all get treasure.
70,000 experience points? Yes, thank you.
Yeah. All right. So let me...
He said all right.
I'm just going to mark it. Yeah, right. Go ahead.
No, I was thinking out loud. 1 second. So that's a pork.
How much XP did we get last time?
We're at 3366.
All right. For those of you watching, thanks for tuning in. Hopefully you had a good time. We enjoyed all your commentary in the comment section down below. So that was a lot of fun. Hundo, thanks for all the stuff adding to the conversation. Zach Stanley, thanks for coming
Christian
in.
D&D.
And I did promise a little pirate she-shanty. So let me think of one on the spot.
There
once was a lad named Zack Stanley. He was there and he brought us glee. There was one who was named Hundo. He was at it and he wasn't a foe.
Okay.
So, yeah.
All right, that was good.
You are a foe.
You get what you pay for.
Where did that premise? Premise?
Oh, no.
Where did that promise come from?
Kramis? All right, all of you have a good time. You have a good night. Thanks for the viewership, and we'll see you possibly next week, maybe?
Goodbye!
See y'all later.